Hi everyone, welcome back to Nancy Artwork. Today, as you can see, I am at Agonda Beach and sharing these beautiful views with all you guys. I thought of expressing and sharing one of my very important day of life. It's my 6th anniversary, and on the occasion of today's, I thought of sharing a token of love to my husband, and also thought of sharing this as a tutorial to you guys, because Valentine is approaching, and at this point in time we all think of giving some beautiful stuff to our loved one. Without further ado, I will just guide you or let you through the journey of how I have created that beautiful animation. So I've just basically picked one pick of our memory and used Procreate to create rose flowers and then small animation using the rose petals. So let's learn how I have created this beautiful artwork, and I'm sure this will be a really quick and short tutorial for everyone. So as you can see, I have added a couple of layers already on this artwork, and now I will show you what brushes I have exactly used. So I have used a technical brush to just outline and fill a petal leaf, and then I have filled it with a pink rose pink color. After that, I have tried to use more petals in different layers, and I have kept each petal in a separate layer so that I can add effects and I can also animate them whenever I want. I'm using another brush which you can see on the timeline, and this brush actually helps me to give a little texture on my leaf, and then I'm also adding opacity to the same leaf. This actually gives that transparency layer to your artwork, which actually helps you to see other petals also around. This gives a very beautiful illusion of a flower. Similarly, I will repeat the artwork along. As you can see, now I am actually repeating all the petals to complete the shape of a flower, and I'm trying that that transparency layer is given and all the edges have a sharp and a darker feel to give that flower a beautiful look. I've also tried to give a little glow effect within the leaves by adding some light color in the center. People who have not subscribed me yet, please go ahead and subscribe my channel. It will be really helpful and motivates me to produce more artwork like these for you guys. Moving ahead, I'll be adding some stem to this flower. I have just randomly made a simple shape of the stem and try to fill in there, but then I thought that this will be a little dark, and I have used small brush which is a textured brush at this point in time, using a watercolor brush pen here, so that I could give that watercolor effect of a leaf, and I'm trying various shapes over it. It's very simple. You can just try 3 to 4 times using your pen in a way that you put up a pressure at the point in place where you want to have a thicker stem, and then loose it off on the pen when you don't want the heavy flow to come out of the way. It's exactly the same way when you do it with a brush on a piece of a paper. So you only need to be careful that where you need to have broader stems, where you need to have thin stems, and then give pressure to your Apple pencil in the similar way. And this is how the look of my whole flower is coming together, and I'm really liking it, and I'm making some fine changes of doing some fine tune at the end to just give the stem the shape I require. And you can redo or do this couple of times. I'm trying to adjust the flower to my artwork, and I feel this is the quite better position for it, because I'm also planning to put in the photo at the background, and this is one of the photo which I've selected. This is one of our memory pic, and because the color of my flower are quite vibrant, so I'll subdue that with a grayscale image. So I'll go to my image background and I'll change the layer to luminosity, so that it, yeah, so it will convert itself to a black and white picture. And now I will darken the background. So this is one of the text to typography I did in the old artwork, and I would like to import this to this artwork, because I think this makes a lot of sense over here to me. And to import this, you need to do only one small thing. To go to your old artwork, just say copy artwork, and go get back to your working artwork and say paste artwork. So it will take all the layers, combine them into one, and put that into your present story. So in that case, you don't have to redo again and again stuff. Okay, so now as you can see, my text is not coming out well on this picture, so I have to darken the background of this image. And this I'm trying to do by adding a black pen stroke at the floor, or sorry, at the ground. And then I will just do multiply this layer with the background layer, so that, you know, the image is also visible and it get darkened in the position where my text is visible and is having a higher or a better contrast. Once I feel comfortable with the background layer, I will keep that as a image in my photo section, and then import that to a new artwork and open Animation Assist on the same. Animation Assist will allow you to add multiple frames, so I will add or duplicate my background layer to 5 layers, so that upon each layer I could produce different petals and different positions, which would prepare a smoothless animation like the leaves are falling. Once you are happy with all the positions, you would like to adjust the frame rate of your artwork to the speed by which you want the leaves to be falling. So I have kept it 7 or 5 at this point in time. So maybe you would like to adjust that with respect to the number of petals you have taken on the frame. It will be totally dependent upon the number of elements you have taken on one particular frame. And now you can just go and play the animation to understand the smoothness of your frames. And once you're satisfied, you can export the artwork wherever you are exporting your rest of the photos or artwork. I will try to export this as a MP4 because I wanted to import it as a video form, but you can also import it as animated GIF. So that was it for today's tutorial, guys. Hope you would have liked today's tutorial, and do let me know your comments in the section below if you need any more stuff to be working up for your Valentine's Day. I'll be producing some more artworks in coming days. My following artwork will be upon preparing a galaxy, and by the meanwhile, if you feel that there are certain more artworks which I can support you for the Valentine's Day, do comment me in the comment section below. Thank you.